well done. You know, very smooth transitions, and from a technical aspect, I loved it.
When the chandelier fell, I almost jumped out of my seat.
Speechless.
I thought it was phenomenal. I loved the singing and the sets and the costumes. It was awesome.
It's definitely something you should go see.
We've seen the movie. It's great, but I think this is better.
I don't know about Devery. Let's find out.
I was excited too.
I thought it was fantastic. It was amazing.
It's my second time seeing it. I love it. Well, we're big nerds and we know everything about it and we do stats and all this nonsense, but it was really good.
There aren't even words. I mean, it was better than the first time I saw it. She cried.
Phantom of the Opera is one of the best love stories brought to Broadway in the history.
Oh, goodness. All of it? Each and every part.
The music of the night.
Yeah, I like that song. When they're down and when they were on the boat and they made it look like they were floating in the water, I really like that part, too.
The boat, and then at the beginning when they made the chandelier like catch on fire, so it looked like all the candles lit up, and at the end when they crashed, and then the boat scene, and then Angel of Music is my favorite song. So that scene was awesome.
Obviously the chandelier. That's everybody's favorite moment. Mine especially.
My favorite moment was when the Phantom and the girl are walking down the steps towards his little lair.
When the chandelier fell and near the end of the movie.
The plan.
Mine was the whole masquerade scene.
Mine was when Christine went to her father's grave.
Does all of it count?
And all the times when the Phantom was singing, it was just, he has a great voice.
The masquerade ball, that was my most treasured and favorite scene of the whole play. And I love that part in the movie. It was just fantastically well put together.
You could, like, hear the Phantom coming from the back and wherever he was supposed to be, or when you couldn't see him, you could hear him. And I was kept turning around, actually seeing if he was there.
How they put together the whole underwater scene with the candles and the candelabras coming out and the boat. And I was wondering how they were going to actually do that. So I was really blown away.
The chandelier coming up at the beginning.
When the chandelier came down and it had a big pop. When the Phantom of the Opera kept on making those, like, flashes.
I saw the show for the first time in 1995, saw Davis Gaines as the Phantom, and this Phantom is just as good, if not better.
A couple times when he was up above, I didn't even realize he was there at first.
There's a part where he's singing, and it sounds like he's over here on this side of the stage, and you're like, I'm looking over here, he's not there. That, and then when the body fell down on the back of the stage.
My biggest surprise was when Phantom was in the center stage and just disappeared from sight instantaneously.
Well, I knew both of the gunshots were coming, but they both still made me jump.
And the chandelier, I just kind of freaked out. Come, please. It's epic. See Phantom of the Opera. It's the best musical ever.
The Phantom of the Opera is here at DSM through March 14th.
Come see it. It's awesome. I loved it. And go DSM on Facebook.
DSM rocks.
It's awesome.
Well, I would invite the two of my friends.
I brought in my kids to see four of the musicals here, and it's been great for them, and I love it. I would like to say that we took the new Green Line DART for the first time, so I didn't have to drive, and that was awesome.
Phantom of the Opera is the best.
Dallas Summer Musicals rocks.
Come see Phantom of the Opera.
Dallas Summer Musicals.
Come see Phantom of the Opera.
DSM.
Come see Phantom of the Opera.
Dallas Summer Musicals. Come see Phantom of the Opera at Dallas Summer Musicals. Woo!